From coast to coast and beyond, people in North America are doing fascinating things to make their cities, towns, and regions more interesting, more successful, and better places to live. Join me, Terry Bradshaw, as I explore all that's new and exciting about the USA and Canada and what people are doing in order to make a difference. It's an easy way to see what's happening across your own country. Welcome to Today in America. Industry has made this country what it is today and will continue to take us forward into the future. Here's a look at how industry works.
Cryogenics is the study of how materials behave at ultra-low temperatures, usually below minus 238 degrees Fahrenheit. Vital industrial gases such as helium, oxygen, argon, and nitrogen, as well as liquefied natural gas, are transported in a cryogenic state because that reduces their volume by a factor of 600. Today, cryogenic solutions allow natural gas to be distributed as a liquid, beverages to be carbonated, metal to be welded and cut, and exotic material to be used for manufacturing the electronics we rely on every day.
By 1925, increasing demand for industrial-grade oxygen necessitated a practical solution for distributing liquefied gases. Lindy responded by pioneering new technologies for the storage and distribution of liquefied oxygen. In 1985, Taylor Wharton acquired the cryogenic equipment businesses of Union Carbide's Lindy division.
One common use of cryogenic techniques is to liquefy natural gas for transportation and storage. This is commonly being done at the wellhead so that the LNG can be transported to market in the most efficient form. Using natural gas protects the environment, saves users money, creates jobs in the oil and gas, service and transportation industries, and fosters energy independence.
What's happening today in LNG is that there's an abundance of natural gas available both domestically and internationally. And everybody's trying to figure out how to utilize it. They can't build pipelines fast enough, so the most efficient way to transport and store LNG is in its cryogenic form, or liquid natural gas. Taylor Wharton manufactures all of that cryogenic storage equipment and transportation equipment, thus we have the opportunity to satisfy the needs of the global industry.
The company also provides the healthcare sector with canisters for life-saving gases, as well as crucial cryogenic technology. Cryogenics makes possible high-power electricity transmission, infrared cameras, and the powerful magnetic fields used in MRI machines. The life sciences field relies heavily upon cryoscience to preserve biological samples, which makes possible animal husbandry, stem cell research, blood banking, and a wide range of medical research.
LabRepco is involved in preserving biological samples. These samples are used primarily in drug discovery research, cancer research, cardiovascular disease, and the other ailments that affect the world today. Taylor Wharton provides us equipment to allow us to store these irreplaceable samples safely and securely.
The small metalworking company that would eventually become Taylor Wharton began operation in 1742 and provided cannonballs to the Continental Army of George Washington. Since then, the company has been involved in supplying material to aid in the construction of the Panama Canal, as well as the building of America's railroad system. Specializing in high-pressure cylinders for liquid and gas storage, the company has provided critical components to the aerospace industry, including NASA's space program and Boeing aircraft, saving 200 pounds of weight from each 747.
We work very closely, very actively with global and regional industries on sample management, sample storage, giving them and educating them, training them on the technologies, the safety, the operating standard operating procedures that we bring to this industry.
Taylor Wharton is America's oldest continuous operating metalworking company, progressing from manufacturing horseshoes to enabling 21st century bioscience that could provide cures for diseases that plague our society.